Bugging out will have to be one of the most difficult things a prepper can do in an emergency. Imagine spending years saving up for a down payment on a house, then you get the house, then you spend money on the repairs, you spend money on just keeping up taxes, you pay your mortgage, and something happens. There's an emergency so severe that you actually have to abandon your house. The place where you acquired your resources, your food, your water, your guns, your ammo, all that stuff. You got to actually abandon that. That could be one of the most difficult things, and that's something that I pretty much underestimated because I've never been a homeowner. And I, when I think about it, yeah, it's got to be one of the most difficult things you can possibly do when you put all that energy, all that sweat into something, and you got to leave it because it's just no longer safe. So I want to talk about what would be my criteria for leaving my home. Even though I don't actually own a house, apartment or trailer or whatever you happen to be in, what would be a criteria I would use? And it's going to be different for each person, but I want to talk about what I would do. Okay, I had this idea because I was watching this TV show, To the Lake. It's about these Russian, it's a Russian show, and it's dubbed in English, so they have English, you can understand it. And it's about these two families, their neighbors, who actually have to bug out because there's an emergency situation. There's a virus. They're in Moscow. There's a virus breaking out. The government shuts down everything, and they're basically trying to get out of their homes, out of their neighborhoods, because one, crime is already kicking up, and two, they want to be out of there before all those people in the city start to run out to the suburbs, trying to escape a desperate situation. So I was looking at this show, and it has a lot of the things you would expect. You know, you have some people carrying a whole heavy suitcases. And I thought to myself, you know, unless you have food, water, guns, or ammo in those bags, why are you carrying heavy bags? You know, family pictures, I mean, hopefully you have that digitized. You can actually put that on a phone or something. You know, I think people should actually work out ahead of time what they want to get. If they have a family, part of their emergency plan should be, okay, if we got to escape, we got to bug out. And you don't even have to label it bugging out. If there's an emergency, we got to go, we got to take some basic resources, what are we taking? That's a discussion I think married couples should have, especially if you're a prepper. Something you should preparing for emergency, something is a discussion you should have. Really important discussion. My criteria for deciding when I want to actually leave, you know, one, it has to be a threat so severe that I couldn't deal with it. A deadly threat that was hours away or less, or maybe days away. It would have to be, I would have to have transportation, reliable transportation, a plan, a route to actually get to a location I need to get to, and a safe place. So I need a place to go. I would feel very uncomfortable bugging out if I didn't have a place to go. But then there may be situations where you may not have a choice. You might have to get out of there anyway. So what exactly would I prioritize? I would prioritize guns, but I might not be able to carry every gun with me. I can't carry all that stuff with me. Just got to work with the bare essentials. Ammunition, I don't need all the ammo because I'm not going to be using every single tool I bring with me. I got to decide what I want to bring right off the bat. And it sort of helps that, you know, I have a plan in place, but it's something I would actually have to bring. Something you might actually want to think about. Food, water. Part of food and water is actually having the food already packed. I recommend getting a tote, some type of container filled with freeze-dried foods, or maybe you can get a mountain house or some type of other freeze-dried food already comes in a container or something. Have it available so you can just pick it up and go. You don't want to start packing up. You want to have stuff that's already ready. That, you can't bring all your favorite clothes. You can't bring all your favorite everything. As far as the kids' toys, you have to be really decisive with that. You know, I think it has its place, maybe a couple. But you have to be willing to say no. If you have a family, you have to be willing to say, hey, look, this is what we're going to do. And it might help to tell them ahead of time. If there's an emergency, we got to go. This is how we're going to do it. This is what we're going to take. You and your husband or wife can talk about what you want to take, but it has to be something where you can just pack up and you'll be gone in about 15 minutes. If it takes you 45 minutes, you're probably taking too much stuff. And the type of vehicle you have really matters too. If you have a small car, you're going to be limited in what you can actually take. Some people wonder why I have a gas guzzler, so to speak. And for me, I don't even worry about gas that much because I don't plan on driving. I don't make long commutes to work typically. And for me, I like the idea of being able to have that utility in a sports utility vehicle, actually being able to pack things in the vehicle. So when I think about bug it out. It's something you definitely have to be prepared for. You have to already have stuff packed right now. Not, oh, things are getting bad, let me start packing up. You should already have some stuff already loaded up in your house right now, ready to go. Food, water filters, that stuff should already be loaded up. All right, so that's my recommendation. What's the criteria you would have to work with? Another thing is you got to figure out what if you're married, what's the other person's criteria? What would make the other person want to leave? Because you can have guns and ammo and all types of cool stuff, but if you have a wife who absolutely will not leave, you may have an issue. Or a husband who absolutely will not leave may have an issue. It's something. So communication and having a plan is important, especially if it's just more than one person. Also, if you're gonna bug out to another location, it might be helpful to have a person who's okay. It might be good to have a person who's already there, because what if you get to that location and there's another person there? You know, what's the plan then? That's something you need to be planning for. That's something you need to be thinking about. When if you get to that secondary location, or maybe you did have family there, you get there and that person isn't there anymore. We got to think about the legal ramifications on your next action. As far as your vehicle, make sure the vehicle is on point. Make sure you always have plenty of gas in that vehicle. If you're the type of person who drives around on E, you may want to change that habit. You may want to change that pretty quickly. If you own a house, you may be able to store gas on your site. It might be a possibility. That's one of the benefits of being a homeowner. Something you might want to think about. You want to have some basic items in your vehicle. First aid stuff should already be there. Tourniquets. You should already have water. You should already have a water filter in your vehicle. You should already have that available. You know, it shouldn't be something where, oh, you're going to make a special... you got to really scramble together things. So, anyway, guys, what will be your criteria for deciding when to bug out? Is something, even if you don't plan on doing it, you have to plan it. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget the future blogs to those who prepare for it today.